Hello, Airbus Cockpit Coach here, and welcome to the channel. In this video, I'm going to run through a commonly asked question by pilots using the 320 series of aircraft, so either the 319, 320 or 321 in the simulator, and that is, why do pilots perform a VLS check? And why are pilots adding a few knots here and there to their approach speed? So it's a good question, and one I hope to be able to explain to you in this video. So just for those that aren't familiar with the acronyms, VLS is our lowest selectable speed. So we've got the perf page here open on the MCDU, which is accessed with this button here, perf, performance approach page, and you'll see our VLS here and our VAP speed here. So VLS is velocity lowest selectable, and VAP is velocity approach, so our lowest selectable speed and our approach speed. And they are indicated, so VLS is indicated by the top of this amber bar here on the primary flight display speed tape, and our approach speed, VAP, is represented by the magenta triangle. Now, the approach speed, or VAP, should always be considered as part of any approach. It's calculated using the aircraft weights, the flap and slap configuration. So if we were to sort of change our expected config for landing around, so config 3 for example, you'll see speed changes and so forth take place. And also the winds, use of anti-ice and auto-throttle use will vary these figures. So obviously based on information put into this approach page. So that's pilot's input information, and it's only as useful as the information you're given, so that could be wrong as well. So this actually is open to some error. So we may have wrong information, we may accidentally put wrong information in, which is a risk. It's important to note that velocity approach, so our approach speed, is the greater of either VLS plus 5 knots or VLS plus a third of the tower reported headwind component, and that's up to a limit of 15 knots. So it can be VLS plus 5, it could be all the way up to VLS plus 15, depending on the wind situation. So your VAP speed can vary depending on the tower reported wind, which you would put into this field here, that magnetic wind. Now there is another function of that the speeds on approach, which is called ground speed mini, but I'll run through that in a separate video, as there's a little bit more to go through on that. But that basically helps us maintain consistent energy and speed across the ground in strong and changing wind conditions. So why do we need to perform a VLS check then? So we're happy with that. And the main reason is because the VLS that's indicated here and the VLS that is there and the MCDU are calculated by two different computers. So this information here is calculated by the flight management guidance computer, which you can see in the MCDU, and the VLS speed here is calculated by the flight augmentation computer, or computers, because there's two of them, and the other wise abbreviated to FAC, or the FACs. And we have two of those computers, which use a whole range of information around the current situation of the aircraft in flight, such as angle of attack, pitch, thrust and centre of gravity, and many more factors which go into to calculating this VLS speed. And it even calculates its own ground weight figures based on that. So it's almost entirely separate to the information that we're putting into the MCDU. So it's another view on VLS. So that can be different, and to demonstrate that, so you'll see we're about 125 knots on the VLS on the speed tape there. So we came up here and we turned off flight augmentation computer 1, and over here on the first officer's side, flight augmentation computer 2, we then see that speed's dropped. It's about 118 knots now. obviously systems have downgraded and so forth. We've got the simulator pause at the moment, so we're not going to have too many problems with it. But yeah, we've lost the information has changed, and we've lost other bits with those computers not available. So it just shows you there is a difference in terms of VLS. So we'll put those computers back on. And you see it's jumped back up again, so 125 knots. Now, because it's calculating differently, it's not necessarily going to maintain that difference we have between VLS and VAP on the MCDU. So actually, I think today we've possibly got, I would say that's a 4-knot difference there, indicated. So I would be considering certainly adding another knot into that, looking at that. Unfortunately, you don't see this VLS speed displayed as an actual figure anyway. You sort of have to make reference to it on the speed tape. But in terms of maintaining a 5-knot margin, at least in today's light wind conditions, I would consider canal coming in and just putting in 130 knots into our velocity approach speed there, making sure that magenta triangle moves up and we have sufficient margin, possibly even another knot, so it's maybe a couple of knots. Just take the simulator off pause. It's out there. Continue on down into Geneva's 1-way 2-2. We can test the autoland capability of the Fenix A319 while we're here. So you want to make sure we're maintaining a sensible margin. Obviously wind speed comes into effect here, and also turbulence at times, buffeting around in the real world. You'll see that speed tape rocking a bit in bumpy conditions and the wind changes around the sensors of the aircraft, and you just want to make sure there's a good margin between that and the VLS lowest selectable speed. With auto throttle off, it's certainly permissible to fly at VLS speed into an approach, but and there are differences between aircraft, pilot preferences, so I actually like to add a few extra knots on the A319 just because it tends to drop a little bit on the approach. It's quite sensitive to taking the speed out too soon, so coming in a few more knots. That's real world though. Also in the Airbus A321, having a VLS plus 10 helps with tail strike clearance, tail clearance on that aircraft, so that's a factor to consider there. There are sort of handling differences between aircraft, and that's something you get used to by experience. So as with everything with Airbus, we've got sort of redundancies, so we've got our secondary calculation there with VLS backing us up, making sure we're safe. So that's what that's all about, having two separate systems calculating the same thing effectively, and we're therefore ensuring we've got good safety margins and an approach speed which is going to give us a predictable landing outcome at the end of it. First spoilers and diesel. A nice auto land, no write-up required on that one. Good auto land performance there from the Fenix A319. So if you've got any questions on what we covered there today, please don't forget to drop those in the comments, and I'll do my best to come back to them. Otherwise, please hit like and subscribe, and don't forget to check out the channel memberships and other videos available there on the 320 series of aircraft. Thanks for watching, and take care.